In the industrial age, new materials compete with wood, and power tools compete with hand tools. In today's fast-changing society, wood is gradually losing favor. How can we revive the reputation of wood? How can we make the use of wood as popular as it was in the past millennium? Zheng Anquan is a well-known online carpenter. His daughter Molly made him popular through her documentary, Papa's Carpentry House. The theme of the documentary is based on solar terms. Each episode covers a different wooden article designed by Zheng Anquan. This documentary on the joy of carpentry has been well received by the public. In addition to designing pieces for the documentary, Zheng Anquan has taken on the task of renovating an old house for his fans. The old house is located on a waterside street in Tangxi, Hangzhou. The ancient canal runs through the town that was once home to many wooden buildings. Zheng Anquan is going to give the old house a more open layout. He knows that a gathering place for carpentry enthusiasts must be carefully planned. Zheng decides to create a new design as his daughter records the process. Today, Hangzhou is a site of great innovation as well as a beautiful riverside city. The city has changed with the times. Carpenters in the city today are going well beyond the traditional woodworking methods.
这个是那个爸爸去年做的一个机关盒，然后呢，这个盒子有一个特色，是它整体都是用木头的，没有任何金属，也没有电子的，或者是弹簧啊，这些都没有。但是呢，它就是要靠三个密码。爸爸，这密码是不是换过了？你过来，你过来。 你过来给我们演示一下。上次那个密码告诉人家了。因为之前有人说这个密码，他们看能不能猜，他说肯定是按的最多的那几个，肯定就是密码。然后后来爸爸因为改了密码之后就按的再多也没有用了。嗯，你给我们演示一下。等等等等。
这个机关整个机关就在这个上面，这个琴键这个按键的下面。 上次有一个学员，他说他就是想学这个东西，他要怎么样呢？为他女儿做一个，做一个给他女婿能打开女儿家很好。他就这样说，啊，我孙子倒也好，他说，那看来我只能教你了。
Zheng Anquan's designs reveal the many marvelous objects that can be made with wood. Like a walking stick that can become a stool. Or a tissue box that is also a puzzle. Zheng strives to explore all the possibilities of wood.
这个里面现在放的是我爸爸做的一些微型的家具，这是一个小豹子，包括里面的这个铜的配件啊，这些也都是他自己去磨的做的。然后还有像这个小凳子，这个小凳子是我们家的那个，就这个凳子，一模一样的那个1:5的比例缩小，因为他担心以后这个大家具可能以后几代就扔了，但小家具还可以一直保存，所以就家里有什么他就量了尺寸，回来画图纸，然后就做一个。
This set of miniature furniture was Zheng Anquan's first project. Wood has always been an important building material in China, and carpenters have explored countless techniques for this simple material, making all types of furniture. This unbounded spirit of exploration and innovation continues today in China. Zheng Anquan is designing some wooden lampshades that include the mechanism. Drawing out the design is a process of translating imagination into a visual representation. This is sometimes torturous.
这一个想不出来的东西，我就不想了。到第二天再说，第二天再去思考。往往就是这样的，一个东西你当一天没想不出来的时候，到第二天或者过两天，或者你到哪儿去玩一会儿，啊，或者哪儿去找一个灵感来，想出来了，就这样。
After several revisions, the lampshade is finished. Now Zheng needs to go through the process again for the camera. The lampshade is made of pieces that fit together like a puzzle. It looks very modern, rather than traditional. The crucial part of the design is that it is easily disassembled. The traditional mortise and tenon joint has a close fit to ensure the article won't easily collapse. But wood can expand and contract, so even the closest fit may become loose, and traditional carpenters take this into account. Zheng Anquan, however, has loose fit for the joints, relying on a locking mechanism to maintain the structure. The holes on the body are drilled at precise angle so that the four pieces can fit together. The pieces hold each other in place to make a secure structure.
相互之间已经牵连，已经牢了，但是它还是要往外面出来的，那么就靠这两根来把它固定，所以我这个肯定要装上去。这一块是卡住这两块，这块对，这你看有个卡口，卡口之间跟这个卡口相连接的，好，就这样卡在一起了。 灯罩我挂在上面，它本身有个重力是往下的，所以我这两个横梁，它是永远是把它拉在一起的。
Without a hammer or nails, Zheng has created a stable structure that can be disassembled and reassembled over and over. In addition, the parts are easy to replace thanks to the loose fit. The design presented a real test for Zheng's imagination and patience. The filming has finished, but Zheng continues working on designs for other lamps for the old house. He goes to the city to use some machines that will speed things up. All four pieces are designed with a loose fit, and each has a different shape and mechanism. The renovation of the old house is nearly completed with the completion of the lamps. Future visitors who watch the documentary will get to see the wonderful changes taking place in woodworking. At first, Zheng Anquan designed things for his daughter's documentary. But after finishing those pieces, he became inspired and decided to continue making things.
传统的东西，好的东西可以留，但是你首先一点要让人喜欢，要让人去爱，让人去做。那么我怎么办呢？这样将我们家年纪大的人也要有一种创新的一种意识放进去，让年轻人喜欢，喜欢了就好，喜欢了有人会去更加的把这些手艺的东西传承下去。
Wood has been used to make many wonderful things during China's long history. Wood is proving just as useful and inspiring today as it ever was. Molly is now editing the next episode of Papa's Carpentry House. Young audiences online will soon see how wood can be creatively used in the old house in Hangzhou. Communication in the information age has changed greatly. The ancient wood culture is now on display on this public platform.
<笑>这一看就是没用过刀子，不会用力。哎，你行，你上。这就是那个我的后台，粉丝有10000多个，互动率非常高的，能达到90%以上的起码，就每期都会有人看啊、刷弹幕啊、评论啊，并且大部分都是大学生。
This is Zhang Xin, a video-sharing website blogger and an undergraduate student at the School of Design, Harbin Normal University. He's taking a year off in Hangzhou to work as a carpenter and post his carpentry courses online.
昨天他是把他的小板凳的教程发布到我们的黑手套上面了，看看你这边有没有什么建议。就是中间这个详情的简介，这个栏目应该再多添一些，包括工时。这个除了制作工时以外，它还要等胶干、等油干。
The developers of a carpentry mobile app recently invited Zhang Xin to post his carpentry courses on their app. Modern tools have made carpentry easier and accessible to more people, but there is also potential danger. There are few standardized carpentry courses in China, so young carpenters often don't learn about safety in woodworking. Zheng Xin has volunteered to be the guide. Here in Hangzhou, Zheng Xin has rented a room with a colleague to save money.
脑洞类的东西，没什么大用，但是还比较好玩的。嗯，就这样一整就开了，就这么一随便一拧就关上了。它就这玩意儿吧，它一转，这个东西就会剥立起来，然后这两个立起来的地方呢，就会卡到这里边这个槽里。Zhang
Xin's videos used to be more about easy to make, innovative articles. Such as wooden roses made from shavings, cell phone stands, etc., hoping to attract more followers. Now, he needs to restructure his courses to be more professional and detailed.
周六6点, 木工房, 直播, 不见不散, 不见不散。
The well-equipped carpentry workshop provides a place and equipment for amateurs to work on their projects. This is also where Zhang Xin works.
I'm going to cut the audio.
Livestream episodes at the carpentry workshop comprise the main way Zhang Xin learns about ideas of his followers.
真的，不是，你看，你看这个，这是用来做补缝的那个木粉。
Before releasing new courses and upgrading his site, Zhang Xin will see how well an episode with detailed carpentry knowledge goes over with followers.
看这个，看到了吗？仔细看，仔细看，仔细看。 它的这个原理呢，就是把木材破成这种薄片，就是一个薄薄的木片，大概是2毫米到3毫米左右，然后用这个这么个模具，然后夹住，完事给它这么压在一起，哇，1000多人了。The
live stream goes well. Zhang Xin believes that his audiences want to know about professional carpentry and practical skills. Moreover, they like his relaxed, humorous approach, which is the style for his new videos.
Okay. Hello, 又见面了啊！本期视频呢，带大家讲一讲这些软件、图纸之类的。
Zhang Xin fills orders to make money during the day and shoots videos late at night. The new course is about making a portable desk. The desk is more practical than some of his earlier videos, but also more complicated.
Hi, 本期视频呢，带大家做那个桌子的面板，需要一个1米2乘25的两块面板。桌子嘛，露在外面的就是看那个两个板子的颜值，然后呢，后面有一些黑胡桃。哎。 其实拍这个视频呢，付出的东西还蛮多的，因为一般我拍一个做一个家具，如果说不拍的话，我纯做，假如说能做一周，然后边拍边做呢，我就叫做2周，因为我要翻镜头来回去取镜。接下来呢，给大家车这个腿，要转之前呢，先检查它这个会不会碰到这个刀架。 嘛，还是有一点辛苦的，因为除了钱上的事情，然后时间上的事情，然后也是很奔波，有的时候吧还得找家里开口要一点点钱，然后去维持一下生活，然后继续把这个事情做下去。但是我相信我做这个事情是有价值的。
It takes a week to basically finish the desk. It can easily be taken apart, making it convenient to move.
现在杭州是30度，而哈尔滨只有12度。我现在只有一双凉鞋了，下车还得买双鞋穿。
Before going back to school, Zhang Xin makes a visit to his hometown. This is where he became interested in carpentry.
老爹，爹，啊。哎呀，哎，
干嘛呀？这是
整点木头木料子。这是我爹，然后这是我那个我于大爷，然后这是刘大爷，然后后边这是我二大爷。以前再早，大部分都是做木匠的，做木工的，就纯手工的。
摔坏了，
是吗？真的，那可能被托运的时候磕着了吧？
也能整，也能整。
就
两边掐上，打上白胶可以。
对，
蒜头嘛，
做过那种完了给它镶上。
蒜头嘛，也
蒜头
蝴蝶结。
They quickly figured out how to repair the desk. They'll make a butterfly joint to fix the crack. Seeing the ingenious craftsmanship of the past and remembering the injuries they've experienced have added to Zhang Xin's determination to create instructional courses.
Okay.
也多年不干了啊。
身体记忆嘛，这身体记住了这个东西。
90年代末嘛，刚大家伙刚开始用这些电的时候，很多时候操作规范也不知道，然后相关的机械设备也不了解，所以说造成很多工伤。
最开始工友牌电炮就是刚弄的，工友牌，我这这么一推，刷下这俩手就蹭到电锯上，把这当时就
扎进去没好。有10个得有5、6个甩的缺手指头。
李叔的那个，
对，
贼起，
贼起，
打麻将，哎，打麻将能不耽误？
As Chinese carpenters switched from hand tools to power tools, they went through a difficult learning curve. When Zhang Xin was a child, he wondered why many older men had missing fingers. As an adult, he hopes to help people avoid this fate.
再高点。我就想着，以后再有新入行的人，让他们有一个规范的视频，可以了解到这里面所涉及到相关的一些安全应该注意到的点。看我视频的人，他们也不会再去受伤。本期这个桌子小视频呢，就到这里了。正好也给大家看了一眼我学校的机房，那么下期见吧。
From homes to household items, and from culture to philosophy, wood has a glorious history. The new generation of carpenters is exploring ways to continue the tradition. In Hangzhou, Zheng Anquan offers basic instruction in his carpentry workshop for fans of the documentary. In Harbin, Zhang Xin is going back to class to learn more about modern carpentry. More and more young people are learning about carpentry through the internet. Their creativity will inject new life into Chinese woodworking.